Welcome back to my channel. My name is Isabel Mahi, and if you see my face for the very first time, please subscribe to my channel and do not forget to give this video a huge thumbs up and drop your comments down below. Okay, so I feel like I need to apologize for being MIA on this channel for the past few weeks. I'm so sorry guys, I'm back now and I promise to be more consistent and drop videos weekly. Today I'm going to be taking you guys along on the step-by-step way I do prep my skin for a flawless skin base, for a flawless foundation, for a flawless skin-like look. So I feel like you need to take skin prep more seriously. Instead of just slapping on a primer and doing your makeup, your skin prep actually matters. How hydrated, how moisturized your skin looks before you actually apply your foundation. It helps your foundation to look more skin-like. If your face is actually dehydrated or too dry, your skin is going to be looking dry and your makeup won't blend, but it's going to look patchy. Okay, so I'm starting with this. So this is the Klairs Supple Preparation Unscented Toner. I always like to start with a toner because it just gives my skin so much more hydration. I really love this toner. It does a great job of hydrating my skin. To be honest, if I just go in with a moisturizer without hydrating my skin, there's no water for the skin, the moisturizer to hold on to. So a moisturizer literally seals up your hydration. So you need to hydrate your skin first of all, and that's why I love going in with my moisturizer. My toner first of all. I always like to apply a toner with my hands. Everyone should get a moisturizing hydrating toner. Now I'm going to be going in with my snail mucin. I feel like you all already know this product. I absolutely love this product. I use it all the time. I use this or I use a serum. But when I'm doing my makeup, I feel like most times I don't need my serum. And if I must use the serum, I use maybe my vitamin C serum. But I just wanted to use this today. So step is the moisturizer. This is also the snail. This is also the snail, advanced snail all-in-one cream. This is from Cosrx. This moisturizer is so lovely. So I always go in with a lot more product under my eyes. Just because this is where I'll be applying a lot of products, my concealers, foundation, setting powder, you're going to bake, a whole lot of things going on. Get it down to the neck. Just massage my face a little. So this helps with blood circulation. Next, I want to do is a little bit of this RandR baobab oil. So I'm going in with this. I'm going to put more under my eyes. Whatever is left. So I'm just going to massage this again. I use this sunscreen. This is the Skin Aqua sunscreen. I actually really love this sunscreen under makeup. It has zero white cast. It gives you the sunscreen protection. This is SPF 50. It blends like a dream. And it just melts and blends so well. It doesn't sting your eyes. I feel like the Koreans are really doing it for me when it comes to sunscreen, because this is a Korean brand. It's a Korean sunscreen, so it just works. Zero white cast. Can you all see how it blended like my skin? Like, most people don't wear sunscreen because they always say, oh, it's too thick, oh, it's so uncomfortable. This sunscreen is so comfortable. Like, it doesn't feel like you're wearing anything except the moisturizer. And I have done layers of products on my face, so, and it feels lightweight. I'm gonna finish this process by doing my lip balm, my Vaseline. now, first of all, I'm going to start with my corrector. I have a lot of hyperpigmentation on different parts of my face, so I'm going to be using this LA Girl corrector, but I'm going to be mixing a little bit of it because this is an orange corrector. I'll be mixing a little bit of it with my concealer so that it gives me a peach look instead of an orange look, because the orange look is just a tad too much for me. I took a bit of the LA Girl corrector, the orange one. Now I'm going to apply, this is my Nuban concealer in 042.5, and I'll just put a bit of it. And then using this brush, and I'm just going to mix these two products. Now it's no longer so orangey, but I feel like I still need it to be less orangey, so I'm going to apply a little bit more concealer. I think I like this, so I'm going to go on. So I'm going to go all over this place. I have a lot of hyperpigmentation. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation, and this is my NYX foundation. This shade is in cappuccino, while the Anastasia Beverly Hills shade is in 430W. So I love using these two foundations when I want to like do a dewy look, because both of them are actually kind of very dewy, from not like very, but they're actually dewy foundations. This NYX actually looks like skin. It's a really good foundation. It's actually budget friendly, and it's really very good, just like a high-end foundation to me. So I applied a little bit of my Anastasia Beverly Hills. Now I'm going to apply a little bit of this NYX. This is my shade here. Okay. So now I'm just going to use this brush and apply my foundation. White Glam Beauty Blender. Whenever I want to blend with a beauty blender, I always take a little bit of products before I go in. That way, the product is not moving from your foundation, from your skin to your beauty blender. I feel like I always repeat that tip because it's really important when it comes to blending with your beauty blender. If not, it might leave patches, or it might just take away all the coverage you've done, which you do not want. So that's one of the tricks when using your beauty blender. So guys, here we have it. This is how I prep my face for a perfect base, for a perfect foundation. Now you can see my foundation, it looks so good, and it doesn't look like, you know, I have tons of products on it. It just looks like my skin. So if you follow this process, these tips I just gave you, you will have a flawless foundation that looks just like your skin and doesn't look cakey, and also would actually last all day long. If you feel like you need a primer and you have oily skin, you can use a mattifying primer, or if you have dry skin, you don't need to use a primer, to be perfectly honest. So if you feel like you have very oily skin, you can just use a mattifying primer or a mattifying foundation. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please do not forget to drop a comment down below and subscribe to my channel.